Hello everyone, in this session we will be discussing about chapter number 3 of accountancy part 2, which is financial statements of a company. Now what does financial statement means? As we have learned in the previous class that financial statements are the final accounts of the company. So financial statements comprises 4 things. First is balance sheet. Second is statement of P&L account. Third is notes to accounts. And fourth is cash flow statements. So as we know, balance sheet is prepared to find out the financial position of the business. Statement of profit and loss account is prepared to know the profitability of the business. Notes to accounts is prepared to calculate the share capital. And cash flow statement is prepared as cash flow statement provides the information about cash receipts, cash payments, or net cash, etc. So in this chapter, we will learn how to prepare balance sheet. Now, balance sheet of a company is divided into 2 parts. First is equity and liabilities. Second is assets. Now, equity and liabilities consist of all the amounts which have been borrowed or which is due to the other parties for the company, and assets are the properties of the business. So equity क्या है? Equity वो amount है जो business owner से लेता है. That means owner is investing in the business and that amount is a liability for the business. And liability is the amount which the business borrows from the third party. That third party can be bank or investors or shareholders etc. And asset is the property of the business. It is a kind of investment in the business. Now equity and liability has 4 parts in balance sheet and asset consists of 2 parts in balance sheet. So equity is a major head in the balance sheet as well as asset is also a major head in the balance sheet. Here is the format of balance sheet. This format of balance sheet is prescribed in Schedule 3 of Companies Act 2013. When you go through the Schedule 3 of Companies Act 2013, you'll get the complete details of the format of balance sheet. Now, when the company is preparing the balance sheet in the current year, the company will mention this as balance sheet as at 31st March 2021. Now, this is the format of balance sheet. In the first will be the major heading, that is equity and liabilities. Now, as we have discussed, equity and liabilities means the liabilities or the amount which the business has to pay to the businessman. As we know, business and businessman are separate entity and we record all the transaction and all the information from business point of view, not from businessman point of view. So whatever amount the businessman is bringing in the company, that whole amount is a liabilities for the company. Now, equity and liability, if this is a balance sheet of company's form of business. In the previous class, we have discussed the balance sheet of sole proprietorship firm. And this is the balance sheet of company's form of business. That is why in equity and liabilities, we have written shareholders fund. In the previous class, we were supposed to write capital because that capital was owner's equity. So here under equity and liabilities, the first part is shareholders fund. Now what do you mean by shareholders fund? Shareholders fund means the fund of the holders who have acquired the shares of the company. So these are the fund of the holders who have acquired the shares of the company. And under shareholders fund, there are 3 subparts. First is share capital. Now what is share capital? Share capital means capital raised by the issue of shares. Next is reserves and surplus. Reserves and surplus are the income of the company. For example, securities premium reserve, debenture redemption reserve. These are included in reserves and surplus. Third is money received against share warrants. Sometimes the company needs the money for a specific period of time. So company issues the share and the moment when the company refunds the money, the company will get its shares back. That is money received against share warrants. Second part is share application money pending allotment. Now in this, the company is receiving only application money. The company has not allotted the shares yet. Third is non-current liabilities. Non-current liabilities means the liabilities which have to be paid after the operating cycle, one operating, which means the liabilities which have to pay after 1 year of time period. So the first sub part is long-term borrowings. Long-term borrowings can be loan from bank, issue of debentures, etc. Second is long-term provisions. These are the provisions which are made for the long term. Third sub part is deferred tax liabilities net. Now, what is deferred tax liabilities? Deferred tax liabilities means when the accounting income of a company exceeds the taxable income, that is known as deferred tax liabilities. And the last one is other long-term liabilities. And the last part of equity and liabilities will be current liabilities. Under current liabilities, there are four sub-parts. First is short-term borrowings. Short-term borrowings means short-term loans which have been borrowed for the period less than 1 year. Second is short-term provision. Third is trade payables. Trade payables includes creditors and bills payable. And the last one is other current liabilities. Now, we will discuss the second part of balance sheet asset. As we have discussed the first part of balance sheet, which was equity and liabilities. So, in asset, there are two parts. First is non-current asset. Under non-current asset, there are five sub-parts. So, the first sub-part is fixed assets. And under fixed assets, there are four sub-parts. Now, under fixed assets, the first sub-part is tangible assets. Tangible assets means those assets which can be seen or touched. For example, machinery, buildings, etc. Second is intangible assets. Intangible assets means those assets which cannot be seen or touched, but its presence can be felt. For example, goodwill, patents, trademarks, etc. Third is capital work in progress. Capital work in progress means, for example, if a company has purchased a building, but that building is still constructing. So we can say that building is in work in progress. So it is example of capital work in progress. Fourth is intangible assets under development. Intangible asset under development means trademark diya hai but wo abhi legally accept nahi kiya gaya. Next is non-current investment. Non-current investment means investment which has been made for the long duration. That is non-current investment. And third part is deferred tax asset net. Now what is deferred tax assets? When the accounting income of a company is less than the taxable income, it is known as deferred tax asset. Fourth part is long-term loans in advances. Loans in advances means the company has given loans to the outsider. And the last one is other non-current assets. So these are the five sub-parts under non-current assets. So second part of asset is current asset. Current asset includes six sub-parts. First is current investment. Current investment means investment which is made for the period of less than 1 year. Second is inventories. Inventories are considered as stock. Third is trade receivables. Trade receivable includes debtors and bills receivable. Fourth is cash and cash equivalents. Fifth is short-term loans and advances. Short-term loans and advances means loans and advances which has been lent to the other party for a short period of time. And the last is other current assets. So this is the full format of balance sheet, and you're supposed to learn this balance sheet to solve the question based on balance sheet. So now we will solve a question based on balance sheet. Here is the question number 1 of NCERT, page number 163. So format of balance sheet is particulars, note number, current year amount and previous year amount. So as we know, in balance sheet there are two parts. First part is equity and liabilities. This is a major heading in balance sheet. Second is assets. So we will write first part. Now, under this, there is in first part, there is four parts. First is shareholders' fund. Shareholders fund, there is no shareholders fund given in the question. Second is application money received. Application money received pending. allotment. This is the second part under equity and liability. So there is no shareholders fund and no application money received pending allotment. Third heading is non-current liabilities. And under non-current liabilities, there is a part which is long-term borrowings. So it is given in the question, debentures are 10% debentures amounting to 2 lakh rupees. And we know debentures are long-term borrowings. So we will write this amount in the current year amount. And the long-term borrowing is rupees 2 lakh rupees. Fourth is current liabilities. And under current liabilities, there is a sub-part called short-term provision. And it is given in the question, provision for tax amounting to 16,000. So we will write this amount in the current year, which is rupees 16,000. So this was the equity and liabilities part where there was no shareholders fund, no application money received pending allotment. Under current liabilities, it is given in the question long term borrowings as 8% debenture, which is 2 lakh rupees. Fourth is current liabilities, and it is given in the question short term provision as provision for tax amounting to 16,000. Now, as we know, in balance sheet there are two major headings. First is equity and liabilities, second is asset. So we have recorded equity and liabilities. Now in assets also there are two parts. First is fixed asset, second is current asset. So first part in asset is fixed assets. And we know in fixed assets also there are five subparts. So in the question there are only two parts given, which is tangible assets and intangible assets. So first is tangible assets, second is intangible asset. So it is given in the question motor vehicles amounting to 4,75,000. Motor vehicle is a tangible fixed assets. So we will record motor vehicle amounting to 4,75,000 in current year amount. Second is intangible assets. So it is given in the question goodwill amounting to 30,000. Goodwill is considered as intangible asset. So we will record the amount of goodwill in current year amount. Now the second part in asset side is current asset. And we know there are six subparts in current asset. So the first subpart is inventories. So as it is given in the question, stock in trade amounting to 1,40,000, also loose tools amounting to 12,000. Loose tools is also considered as inventory. So the inventory total of inventory will be 1,40,000 plus 12,000, which is 1,52,000. Next subpart is trade receivables. So in trade, we know in trade receivables there are two things. First is bills receivable, second is debtor. So it is given in the question bill receivable amounting to 1,20,000. So we will write 1,20,000 in trade receivables. Third is cash and cash equivalents. So it is given in the question cash at bank amounting to 1,35,000. So we will write this amount in current year 1,35,000. And the last one is other current asset. So here in the question other current asset will be preliminary expenses amounting to 2,40,000 and discount on issue of shares amounting to 20,000. So total of 2,40,000 and 20,000 is 2,60,000. So this is how the question based on balance sheet is to be solved. In the next session, we'll continue with some more questions. That's all for today. Thank you.